Emily here. Today we're going to learn how to read an audiogram. I am so glad you're here with me. Today, are you going to learn to read an audiogram for yourself, a child, a family member, a friend, a loved one? Why are you wanting to learn this skill? I want to hear down below. Let me know if you're learning for yourself or someone else and who. Also, if you haven't already, please like this video or stick around to the end so that you can like it. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel. My goal is to increase awareness to the deaf and hard of hearing, and this is one way I'm doing it. So if you can please like, share, and subscribe, that helps so much. Thank you. I hope you stick around for this whole video because I'm going to show you my own audiogram. And this is incredible and important because you can understand what kind of loss I have, and you can understand whether your loss is close to mine and what it looks like. If you stick around to the end of this video, I'm going to share another portion of the audiogram and what that means. So today we're going to specifically talk about the audiogram section of it. So it's important to understand why we chart hearing. We chart hearing so that we can understand how a specific person's ears calculate sound and whether or not they can understand or hear or process that sound. So this chart, the audiogram, helps us understand that. In this chart, you are seeing the highest and lowest levels of sound that a person can hear and also the frequencies that they can hear. Let's get into it. Okay, first we have the vertical axis. And when you're looking at an audiogram, it's going to be on your left side. So the left vertical axis is hearing in decibels. Decibels or dBs. Okay, so what are decibels, you ask? Decibels are degrees of loudness, and it is on an exponential scale. 10 and 20, 20 is 10 times greater than 10, and 30 is 10 times greater than 20. So it's an exponential scale. That's something to keep in mind. So to give you a gauge, as you can see on the audiogram, it goes from negative 10 decibels to max out at about 120 decibels. But I want to give you a gauge. So, for example, 10 decibels is breathing, 20 decibels is a whisper, 50 decibels is a quiet office, 60 decibels is conversational speech, 80 decibels is about the sound of a vacuum cleaner, 105 decibels is the sound of a motorcycle. FYI, fun fact, you should be wearing ear protection at any sound above 85 decibels. Ranges of decibels or sound loudness create thresholds, and it's through these thresholds that we categorize how, I guess, good, normal, or profound, or not good, someone's hearing is. From negative 10 decibels to 25 decibels, this is considered normal hearing for adults. Now, a caveat here, for children, it is different. The normal hearing threshold for a child can be 0 to 15 decibels for kids. 16 to 25 decibels can be considered a slight loss for a child, so it is important to consult with your pediatric audiologist if your child's hearing is in that range. The next threshold is 26 decibels to 40 decibels. This is a mild loss. People with a mild loss can experience difficulty hearing in noisy settings. The next range is 41 decibels to 55 decibels. This is a moderate loss. The next threshold is the 56 to a 70 decibel threshold. This is considered a moderately severe loss. The next threshold is 71 to 90 decibels. This is a severe loss. This means that people have difficulty understanding in all settings. And the last threshold is any loss greater than 90 decibels. Anyone with this loss would have complete difficulty communicating orally, lingually, in any situation. Here's a quick refresher. Now we're going to talk about the top axis along the top horizontal axis. Along the top, you see frequency in Hertz. Hertz measure the frequency of sound. This means pitch. So think about a piano. You have the low notes on the left side when you're looking at it, and the high pitch notes on the right side. Can you hear that? That's exactly how it's measured on the audiogram, in different levels of Hertz. Fun fact, humans can hear up to 20,000 Hertz, but because speech occurs from 0 to 8,000 Hertz, that's what we measure because speech is what develops the brain, and that is most important. So as you can see, there are some letters scattered throughout my audiogram. These letters make up the speech bubble. Vowels are known to be lower pitched or frequency or Hertz sounds. So they're towards the left side of the audiogram. Consonants are hard sounds and are typically higher pitched. Thus, they're closer to the right. But it's important to understand where the speech bubble is so that people can realize where their hearing loss is in relation to speech. Fun fact, if someone complains that people are mumbling, it's highly likely that they may have a high Hertz or high frequency loss because they're missing the consonants of all the sounds. If anyone has a low frequency loss, they're missing the bulk of the word, all of the vowels. And this is very common in children if they have losses. For me personally, I have an easier time hearing low sounds than I do high sounds. So male voices are actually easier for me to hear than female voices. And this is because I have better hearing in the lower Hertz ranges. Okay, next, the last portion of learning how to read an audiogram is understanding what the symbol and the colors mean. Is your audiogram in color? If not, no fear, they usually are not. If yours is in color, you're gonna notice two colors, red and blue. Red stands for right because red is right, and blue stands for left because blue is left over. So there's blue and red. So whether or not your audiogram is in color, you're going to see symbols on this graph. O stand for the right ear, and X's stand for the left ear. How do I remember this? Because right stands for, oh, right. We hearing people do it all the time. Oh, right. And then X's are for the left, as X waves, and waves are blue. So that's how I remember them. How do you remember them? If you have special little tips or tricks, I want to hear it in the comments below. If you don't have a system yet, you can use mine. I've taught you how to read an audiogram. I hope it was helpful. If you ever have any questions about your audiogram, do not hesitate to ask your audiologist what it means. Now, my audiogram comes with a key, but still, there are some terms that are hard to understand, like unmasked bone conduction. Check that out. If you have questions, don't hesitate to ask your audiologist. They are there to help you and answer your questions. So thanks so much for sticking to this video. I'm going to show you my complete audiogram. So if you look at this, you notice that at 250 Hertz, my hearing is in the moderate to severe range. And as the Hertz continue, my hearing loss has a significant drop at 250 to 1000 Hertz. It goes up a little bit to 2000 Hertz. Both ears are the same at 3000 Hertz. Kind of interesting, and then they trail off from there. You can see the difference between my right and my left ear. My left ear has always done better than my right ear. People close to me know that my left ear is my better ear, and they go to the extra effort to make sure that they're on my left side. Whether it's my running buddy when we're training for a marathon, she runs on my left side so that I can hear her as we talk and we run. And also my husband, whenever we're in the car, I prefer to sit in the passenger seat while he's driving because I can hear him better because my left ear is facing him. Whether or not you're here today to learn how to read an audiogram for yourself or a loved one, pay attention to your good ear. Look at your audiogram, figure out what your good ear is, and use that to your advantage. If you have people around you and you want to hear them, go on the side where your best ear is facing them, or sit in a way that you're able to hear them better. Also, I want to tell you, on the audiogram, there can be a section for speech audiometry, which takes into account the decibels and the hertz, and figures out and calculates how well you can discriminate or understand what you're hearing. It's really interesting because people are like, oh, can't you hear me? Well, hearing and understanding are two very different things. So for instance, according to my audiogram, I have 72% discrimination in my right ear and 88% in my left ear. But then again, that metric also determines which ear is better. I can just discern better in my left ear. Again, another reason why I face people. So there you have it. Now you know how to read an audiogram. I hope this has been helpful. If you have any questions, please let me know in the comments below. Again, I'd love to know whether or not you're learning how to read an audiogram for yourself or someone else. I hope you take a chance to please like this video and subscribe to my channel so that I can continue to make more great content for you. I hope you guys have a wonderful day, and I'll be in touch. Have a good day.